Okay, and now what we do is we sand around the edge to give it a key so that the adhesive can stick. When we put the sealant on the window, it will quite often cover up the line that you originally have, so that when you put the window against it, you'll find it hard to line it up. So what we've done is we've put little markers about a centimetre further around the edge, so that we've still got a guide when the original masking tape's been covered up with the sealant. Now it's time to sand. Stage is to put the VHB tape around the window frame, equally spaced in between the opening and the edge of the masking tape. It doesn't have to be perfect. Right, I'm using Puriflex 40, and what I'll do is I'll put this on either side. And now what we do is we smooth it all out with something with a straight edge.
There's the paper.
No, I'm alright at the moment. I could probably do with some at some point though, so I might as well get it handy. A sheet off for us.
Have a bin okay? Yeah, anything you're using as a bin?
I did, but not at the moment, no. It's alright, we'll use this. Yeah. That was me. Okay. Now peel the strip off. Thank you.
blocks. You're a bit low on block.
I'll just okay, I'll switch somewhere in afterwards. Yeah. Just remember to mark it. Rest it on the. Just want to get into position. Hold on, Dad, he's not in position yet.
Right.
Need to come left a bit. That's it. I can't see my markers.
I think you're too far left.
Oh yeah, yes we are, yeah. Yeah, I forgot it was a centimetre, wasn't it?
Yeah, it's about right now. I think?
Yeah.
Going?
Yep. If not, forever hold your peace.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay, we've left it a day to give the sealant time to solidify. It does take longer to get right through the core, so it's not really ready for sailing at the moment, but now we can take off the plastic protection on the perspex. Side reveal. I didn't want to leave it any longer than a day because this masking tape, especially with it having rained, has now got all soggy. And if you leave masking tape on too long without removing it, then it also sticks to your boat and you can't get it off. Okay, so on the edges, where I'll just point here, this is the trim. It's the plastic protection that you've got on the window, and you've got the black sealant. And what I've done is I've put the sealant all the way actually onto the edge of the trim of the protector. So what originally was a matte paint underneath has now got the rubber on it, but I've rubbed my finger along it very thinly, so that I've got a thin spread of the sealant. And then when I take off the plastic, comes away nice and clean. In some places, as you can see here, it's flared a bit. You can get rid of that just by rubbing and a little bit of nail action, and that will get rid of it. And it's purely where the paint's coming off the plastic protector. Okay, so now for the big reveal. And just a couple of little bits that need scraping off with the fingernail. But what I can say is a big thank you to my dad, who's helped me, because you can't put those windows in by yourself. You definitely need two sets of hands. Just another quick note, you might say, what about the holes you've left behind? As you can see from the previous video, from this video, it's raining. It's not the best of weather in October, so the best option for me is to fill these with epoxy after I put the windows in. Make sure you don't get any on your windows. Possibly, if you want, leave the protective covering on before you epoxy, or just be very, very careful, because once you get it on the perspex, you're gonna have problems. Ideally, if you had time and you could leave your boat open overnight, or you had a lot of time in the day, you could, once you've taken the windows out, you could fill those with epoxy, wait a couple of hours for it to cure to a point where you can then work on top of it.